No doubt, sir. Okay. Now we are going to cover the implementation part. Okay. So first we will go OpenCV lane detection. So this is the road. Okay. And we wanted to segment out the lanes from here because it is one of the features we have in a self-driving car. So this is how we are going to segment it. So we will see how we performed it using the OpenCV. Okay. Okay, are you, is my screen visible to you guys? Yes or no? Yes. Okay. No, it's much better, I guess. Can you see the Jupyter notebook clearly? Yes, okay. So, yes. Okay. So first we will import the libraries which we are going to use. We imported the OpenCV library. How we import it? This is the import function which help us to do this task. So import CV2. Basically, this you have to specify CV2 in order to import OpenCV. Okay. I imported the NumPy also as NP, and I imported the Matplotlib also. Okay, for plotting the, for showing this image. Also I can use the OpenCV functions IMSO also. But in OpenCV, if you use the IMSO function, you will get a different window. A different window will pop up. Whereas if you use the Matplotlib, it will be in your Jupyter notebook. So you will not get any other window. So that's why I use. You can use the IMSO of the OpenCV as well. So first I specified the path of the image which I am looking for, in which I will going to segment out the lanes. Okay. So this is the path, and this is the CV2.imread and I specified the path. This is how I read the image. Okay. Okay, so now moving forward, I have converted this VGR image to an RGB image because, guys, I already told you Matplotlib read the image in a RGB format. The IMSO function will read it in a RGB format. So if you give a VGR format to a plt.imso function, then it will give you some different image conditions. So first I convert it to an RGB format. So this is the image in which we are working. Here you can see the dimension of the image. We can see the dimension using img.shape. So here it will give you the dimension. This is this is number of rows. Rows means you have height. This is height. This is width. And this is number of channels. This is an RGB image. We have a 3-channel. Okay. Now this is very big image. I want to resize it because because I wanted to have some efficiency in terms of time complexity. So I resize it into a 400 into a 400. So this is how an image look like after we resize it into a 400 into 400. Okay. Now you wanted to segment these lanes in a road. So what you can use, I already talked about it, the segmentation method. So what you will use, thresholding. You will apply a thresholding in order to segment the pixels in your image. So for the thresholding part, you need to convert the image into a grayscale. So this is, I have converted the same image using CVT color method to, okay. We can see we have a doubt. Will you share this code, sir? Okay, yes, we will share it. Don't worry about it. Okay. Focus on the implementation part. Okay. So, CVT color. And this is how we converted this image into a grayscale. So, this is the grayscale image looks like. PPT as well, sir. Okay, guys, please focus on the implementation part. We will share everything. It's open source toward machine learning. Okay. Functions to load the image. So I have incorporated all these things in a single function so that it will be a handy for us. So I define a function load image in which I read the image, I resize it, and I convert into a RGB format. And apart from this, I use a Gaussian blurring here, because I already mentioned you that resizing increase a Gaussian resizing introduce a Gaussian blurring in the Gaussian noise in an image. So in order to denoise the image, we will have to use the Gaussian blurring. So here I use a Gaussian blur. I give the image. The kernel is 3x3, which I am going to use. So this is how our image looks like. Okay. This is the grayscale image. Okay. Now, thresholding only works if we have a high contrast image. If you have a high contrast, then thresholding will work better. So we need to increase, we need to add some contrast in an image. How we can do it? We have a function convert scale AVS. This function helps us to add the contrast in an image. So this is the basic, what you can say, mathematical explanation behind it. This is the matrix. You can think of it as a matrix, and this is a F matrix. The alpha beta parameters is basically used for contrast control and brightness control. Alpha controls the contrast, beta controls the brightness. So here I specified alpha is 1.5 and gives the grayscale image, and beta is 0 because I do not want to increase the brightness, because I think it's clear. I need to increase the contrast, so because it looks a little darker. Okay, so this is how the increased contrast image look like. Okay, now we will apply a threshold layer because we need to segment this white pixels from the dark one. So in segmentation purpose, what I've used, I use the 235 as the thresholding, because guys, you know that that a white pixel corresponding to a 255. If you have a 255, then it is it is known as a white pixel. It will be a brightest white pixel. So I only want to bother about the white lane here. So I will use a threshold of 255. So this is how the image looks after thresholding. Now you can see you have the lane, but you have some other things also. You have this thing, you have this thing also. And you can see the image is, the lane is not, what you can say, is not continuous. We have some black impurities, noise here. So then, we can edge detect after this to get the edges so that we can plot the contour. Okay. So this is how we perform a detection. After the clear detection, we are going to dilate the edge, because here you can see we have a black impurities. We want a continuous contour in order to plot. So we specify a kernel. I already specified you the kernel will be a one kernel of ones. And this is how we dilate the image. So this is how the looks, the result look like after dilating. Okay. Now we find the contour. So the thing here is, here you can see we get, okay, we will see. After applying a fine contour, we will get a list which have all the contours in the image. So what can be a possible contours? This can be a one of the possible contours. Okay. And this can be a one, this can be a second, this can be a third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and this can be a one contour as well. This can be a one contour as well. This can be a one contour. So we will get a list after this. So what I have done is I have sorted that list and I have plotted the biggest contour, which you can see here. So if you plot, so this is how the image looks like. Okay. So this is how we segment the lanes. The thing is, this is just a very basic image segmentation, lane detection I have implemented using the OpenCV. We have furthermore advanced techniques also. We can use the what we can do. We can crop the region from the image. Okay, so you get the desired region of the interest, and then you will apply all these filter there. Okay, and we will have another method also, Hug Transform. So that will help us in many things. We do not have to find the contours and sorting all those things. It will do it for ourselves. Okay. Now moving back to some advanced lane detection. So in advanced lane detection, what we can use? We can use a CNN classifier so that we can increase our accuracy. So basically, in industry level, we use the CNN classifiers and other things. So this is just for the practice, all the things which I have said, because I have covered all the functions which I have taught you. Okay, let's look some of the more optimization. We can do a little optimization here. So this is the complete function. I have converted into a simple function, and these are all the operations we have. So let's see, this is an image. This is how we segment the lanes. Now we have another image, and this is how we segment it. But you can see we have a lot of noise here. This is not at all good. If you are using an self-driving car, it will get crashed. Okay, so we need to further improve it. Okay, so for the improvement purpose, what I have done is I have just changed the kernel ether. In my previous case, I am using the kernel which is of once matrix, but here I am using this kernel. So this kernel will help us to focus more on the what you can say edge thing, because I told you about the working object deletion, so, and help us to get the longest contour. Okay, and apart from this, I also use a Sobel filter here before a Kenny edge detection. So this Sobel filter is also an edge detection filter I told you, but in Sobel filter we do not get all the better result. We just get temporary type of result, and after that we use a Kenny edge detection over the same Sobel filter. So in order to get rid of the small edges where it is. Okay, this small edges. So if we use a Sobel filter, then these will not be considered, because it will only consider the brightest high frequency edges. Okay, that is more predominant, and then we will use the Kenny on those predominant edges. So this is the result after doing some two optimization in a simple function. And this is our previous case, and this is how it goes. So that is all about the lane detection, guys. The second thing also have so many of the downfalls if you are going to use if you are going to take further more different examples. So we need to use an deep learning algorithm or CNN architecture in order to train the lane detection, and this is just a basic, but if you will do the deep learning, if you will create that thing also, the classifier, deep learning classifier, then you in this you also need all those functions to work. Because if you're not aware of these functions, you can't build a classifier, because building a classifier is a second task. First is the pre-processing stage. So in pre-processing stage, you need to convert it to a grayscale. You need to do the image enhancement also. You will apply a threshold also. Then you will train your CNN architecture and many more things. Okay. High order attendance. Okay.